Refresh tokens are part of the OAuth spec, and they make it easy for you to take a short-lived access token and refresh it. If you've been following our series AuthKit in any JS framework, you may have noticed that we're getting logged out in just a matter of 5 minutes, despite the fact that our session is valid for 7 days. In this video, we'll take our session refresh token and exchange it for a new access token. We'll do this all behind the scenes so the user is none the wiser. Let's dive in to AuthKit refresh tokens. In our AuthKit dashboard, navigate to authentication and jump all the way to the bottom where you'll see sessions. By default, AuthKit defaults to a 7-day session length and a 5-minute access token duration. For today's exercise, I'll use a 1-minute access token duration, which is the minimum value, so we can see all of the errors quickly without having to wait 5 minutes between each change. All right, let's jump back into code. This is where we left off on our dashboard page following the initial authentication code flow. When we go to that page, we'll have to log in, dashboard, and I'll use Google. Perfect. Now, as soon as we pass that 1-minute access token duration, this will fail and we will land in this catch block. So to see the error that we get, let's just render that response into the browser. JWT expired, exp claim timestamp check failed. To handle this exception, let's try a new try block. And for starters, just render out our refresh token. Refresh, and there it is. Now we want to exchange this refresh token for a refreshed session. Do this by calling the WorkOS user management authenticate with refresh token function, passing in the client ID and refresh token. This will result in a refreshed session, which we then need to encrypt using the same method that we did in our auth callback, seal data from iron session. Looks like we need to import that, passing in the refreshed session and our cookie password. Let's log that to make sure that everything that we expected to happen happens. Save, refresh, and there we are, our encrypted session. Finally, we need to set our encrypted refreshed session using whichever syntax your framework requires and our options. Now, we want this to be invisible, so we're not going to respond with anything. We're going to let the page render. But for our own visibility, we'll console log session refreshed successfully to observe that it happened inside of our logs. Let's save, refresh. We have an error here because we already exchanged our previous refresh token, but didn't set it on the cookie. So in this one case, we'll need to log back in again now that all of our functionality is in place. So on the dashboard, our first login attempt, we don't see our console log session refreshed successfully because this is our initial access token. But once we've given it a full minute, we can refresh, see that we're still logged in with our authenticated dashboard page. And that for this render, our application automatically refreshed our access token using the refresh token available. This will continue to happen in the background for as many times as we need until we finally hit that session limit. Okay, so access tokens, refresh tokens, sessions, I know it's a lot, but how does this come into play in practice? In our last video, we introduced you to AuthKit RBAC support through roles and permissions. As an admin, we may change the roles and permissions of any given user. Might change someone from a member to an admin, or change the permissions that are available on any given role. So our access token duration, in a very practical way, becomes the max amount of time that a user may have to wait before experiencing those new roles and permissions. I know that this is a lot, so I'm excited to let you know that we have some really cool changes in store with the Node SDK to make this even simpler. But I'll save that for our next video. Make sure you get subscribed with notifications enabled to see that next video. If you want to see how we got here, check out this video up here. And if you want to learn more about RBAC support with roles and permissions, check this video out right here. Thanks for watching. I'm Chintastic. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.